All right.
Come on. I haven't won a single game so far.
Even in Isaac, man.
I won Isaac.
Even in Isaac, though. I don't even know. I gotta, like, sit down with Ed, get him to break down the fucking tables for me or something.
You need to go to, like, math school.
Yeah, I need to do some game theory.
Do some statistics classes. I hear BizSnap's a lecturer, actually, so you might
want... Yeah, it doesn't surprise me.
All right. I can catch that.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised.
So I got this chocolate beer the other day. I thought maybe you'd want to talk about that. How do you feel about weird beers?
What kind of chocolate beer was it?
It was Young's Double Chocolate Deluxe. All right, you're laughing at me.
I don't know. There's something about that collection of words in that particular combination. Young's Double Chocolate. Like, something about that is like, you should be...
Whoa!
He got tripped up there. So he left a skateboard on the staircase. Dude, I'm all right with that kind of stuff. I'm a hit or miss with chocolate beers. I've had some that are, like, nice, and then I've had some that kind of just tasted like alcoholic Ovaltine. But I can get down with some some weird-ass beers sometimes. Sometimes I think, like hazelnut beers, though, they, like, overdo it, get a little bit too much of that, you know, whatever extract it is in there. But...
Well, I'm very new to this whole idea. I'm very not worldly when it comes to beers. So this is probably the first sort of novelty beer that I've had, if not like maybe the second. It's not, I'm not deep on that. And I found it to be very bad.
Really?
It was very bitter. That particular one. Maybe there's better ones for me, but it was very, very bitter. The chocolate taste was pronounced, but it was overshadowed entirely by the bitterness.
Mm.
So
was
I didn't really want
to. Was it a stout?
It was a stout, yeah.
Oh, okay, I could explain it. Or it might just be bad. I don't know. But, it depends what you're into, you know?
My preferences are different.
It's not really like a Bud Light with lime type situation. It's like...
Oh, I didn't think it would be.
There's
I just didn't know what to expect. I've never really had it.
There's a really nice beer coming out of Quebec. This brewery is called McCausland. And they make an oatmeal stout. They've made it for probably... 15 years or something right now. Actually, oatmeal stouts, I guess, are not that uncommon, but it's got like some nice notes of chocolate and coffee and oatmeal, and it's fucking delicious, man.
How do you like that return
that
fire?
That was actually awesome, and I think that's gonna go in. I don't think I can stop it. Nicely done.
Oh, shit. Is that oatmeal got me all worked up? That was an implication that I'm sexually aroused by oatmeal.
I get it, yeah.
All right, breakaway.
It is different, though, like...
Oh, no. There goes that.
When my dad was here, like, a year ago, and...
Is he an oatmeal guy?
He's not an oatmeal guy. He's a... Oh, shit, it's a tie right there. He's, like, a normal beer guy, drinks a lot of lagers, drinks a lot of ales, and we gave him, like, this West Coast beer called Pyramid Apricot Ale, which is a pretty fruity.
That was really good.
I like it a lot. It's very, you know, easygoing kind of beer. A little, like, very, very fruity. And my dad had it, and he's just like, I don't like this shit at all. So I think it's, you know, it's a little bit of an acquired taste, but a lot of alcoholic things are.
I think with me, the idea of beer in general, I had to get used to. So I think then getting used to, like, darker beers and things is just another layer that I'm going to have to kind of spend some time on.
Yeah, I mean, if you're into it.
I don't know if I am, but I should at least give it more of a chance.
I've been going through multiple
phases.
Oh
my god, that chest bump.
Like, when I started out, I only really drank lagers, and it was, you know, I was like, this...
Yeah.
My favorite beer is the beer that tastes least shitty. And then I got into, like, dark beers. I was like, these can actually be pretty good. And then I started drinking, like, a lot of IPAs. And that's, like, the exact opposite situation where you're like, this is awful. And then one day it just sort of clicks and you're like, I want some more of that awful shit inside of my body. Give me some more socks, basically. So that's where I'm at right now. Oh, little nice little cheeky toe poke right there.
Well, I started with the, like, teenage bullshit, like, Bud Light Lime.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Cited that example. I actually started on that. And, I you know, landed somewhere on Blue Moon, which I think is kind of, like, at least a little more respectable, right?
I think Blue Moon's all right, yeah.
Is that actually...
really good... Oh, no!
Oh, my God, I thought that was going in. You
there
put...
You go.
Oh, come on.
Dude, I'm going to be honest with you. That was an accident. I was trying to, like, good. I was trying to sneak around.
You did that on purpose. I was going to be upset.
No. Oh, hey. Oh, all right.
IPA makes me gag. Wow.
Dude, I believe it. Here's the secret about IPAs, though, man. Stouts do this a lot, too. But IPAs, because of the strong flavoring, they oftentimes let you get away with a little bit more alcohol percentage as well.
Right.
So you can have like a 9% double IPA.
Oh. Oh, oh.
Oh, snap. Oh, it's going.
Even off the body. Holy shiz.
I'm not elitist about beer, Chad. You can drink whatever you want. If we went out together and you're like, oh, I'll have a Kokanee, I'll be like, that's cool, man. I'm glad you found a beer that you like. Also, that's really cheap, so good for you. That's fiscally responsible.
Someone told me there's a chocolate Sam Adams that's part of, like, their special collection that I needed to check out, but it's, like, hard to get a hold of, so I need to, like, look into that.
Shit, man.
Apparently, it's delicious.
We missed out.
Yeah. No, I know.
We're there, like, a week and a half ago.
Oh, whoa.
Ronaldo with the screen.
That was quite a shot.
Thank you. Thank
Deserve
you.
That.
Everyone needs their local shit beer now and then. In Vienna, we have Skull. Yeah, I agree with that. You gotta have a shit beer now and then.
Isn't Skull like chewing tobacco?
Oh, this is with an O but no A.
Oh, okay.
Perhaps even like an umlaut situation. Skull is the shit, man. Apparently, Skull's the shit. Skull is the schlitz, man.
Sam Adams made a really good chocolate stout, but I don't think they made it more than one a year. Or more than one year. Oh, so maybe it's just gone now. All right. There'll always be more beer.
There will always be more beer. It's taken off, man.
I think it's one of those things that, like, it'll be one of the last things to go as far as novelties. If, like, shit really hit the fan. Like, economy collapsed, nobody had anywhere to live.
I'm starting to think that this beer idea might catch on, Nick.
No, I'm saying it's like, it started long before civilization, and I think it's going to outlast it, too.
I mean... That's the thing. Alcohol is very easy to make, man.
Right.
You accidentally make it.
Make it. Toilet.
Yeah, you make it in fucking prison, man. I will say, I'm not a beer snob, but if there's one thing I'll be snobby about, I really don't understand. And if you like this, this is fine. But I really don't understand Coors Light, Bud Light.
All right. What do you mean?
It just tastes like beer-flavored water, slightly less beer-flavored because it's light and it's like really watery. But you can get beers if your number one defining characteristic for a beer is like, you know, I don't want it to taste like beer. You can get beers that are totally like that that are not Coors Light, which basically just tastes like diluted beer to me.
Isn't it just sort of a marketing name recognition thing? Like people know that this is beer. And they don't really think too hard about the whole thing. And they go, well, I want a beer that doesn't taste like beer. And these are who makes those.
I guess.
They don't really look far into it beyond that. Damn.
It's cheap? Okay, maybe that's... I forgot that in the U.S.
Is it cheap?
Coors Light maybe is cheap in the U.S. But in Canada, Coors Light is actually... It's not expensive, but it's like one tier up. At least in where I grew up, it's like one tier up. From like absolute budget beers. Which is weird, because I don't actually think Coors Light is an import here. I think it's considered domestic. Like, I don't think there's, like a Coors Light, Virginia. It's like...
Right.
You know, it's like a UNESCO Heritage World Site, but it's actually, instead of being, like, Stonehenge, it's just, like, a huge-ass factory.
Take it!
Ah, oh, shit. You just
take it!
Crushed my defense there.
You fucker, take it!
Oh! That was, you did the pivot and I was so ready, but then you hit it with your off foot.
That was kind of lucky placement. Oh, don't run on top of it, you dingo.
Hey man, I saw somebody say I love craft beers, but a super cold Coors Light on a hot day is great. You're not going to hear me say the otherwise, or hear the opposite. If I'm, you know, we're doing some yard work or something and somebody says like, hey, do you want some juice or I also have Coors Light? I'll be like, you know what? Give me some Coors Light.
So it's like the refreshment of water, with the reminder that beer exists in the world.
If then I went, do you have anything but Coors Light? I'd probably, and he said, like, I've got a, I don't know, like a fucking anything. I'd probably be like, I'll take the anything, but unless it was like, you know, Old English or something like that. I really don't understand malt liquor, but maybe that's just because in Canada it costs like the same.
You gotta ask Rob about malt liquor.
Is it in the U.S. is malt liquor like cheaper per unit cost than beer?
Very, very.
Okay,
cheap.
In Canada it's basically the same like per alcohol milliliter.
It's very accessible and very cheap, I think, is kind of the big selling point for malt liquor.
I guess relatively portable.
Yeah, I guess, but like beer is just as portable, I think.
Well, I mean, if you were like drinking it on the street, like one bottle of malt liquor.
Put a paper bag around all of it.
Yeah, but one bottle of malt liquor at like 9% is like twice as much.
The concentration.
Yeah,
saying.
Alcohol per kilogram.
I mean, why not just put a fucking airplane thing with vodka in it in your paper bag or whatever?
I mean, you could do that, but that's
get
probably
a flask. How
get
about
a little
that?
Bit more expensive, maybe.
Yeah. Well, vodka's not that expensive, is it?
I don't know, man. You tell me.
I don't think it's that expensive.
I know people can play Edward 40 Hands with the malt liquor. That's one of the... I hesitate to call it legitimate, but that's one of the only legitimate things that in Canada I can see you using malt liquor for. Personally, I only drink mead. Hand-brewed by a Swedish jarl deep in the fjords of Malmo.
Where do you actually come up with this shit?
I know like four Swedish cities. And Malmo seemed like the funniest.
It was.
Yeah, probably.
I mean, I have no idea what the other ones are, but it was.
Yeah, you got Stockholm. Gotland.
The syndrome.
You've got Malmo and you've got Uppsala.
Uppsala's honestly pretty good too, though.
Uppsala's pretty good, I'll admit. They had the Olympics there one year. In like the 50s or something. Like maybe the 1850s, I can't remember.
They've got to have some really great runes then.
Probably, yeah, it wouldn't surprise me.
I kind of want to devote my life to documenting all of the prior Olympic cities. Like all of the runes that they left behind.
Mm.
Make like a photo book. Well, that could be real cool.
You missed your chance here in Vancouver, man.
Yeah, I could go back.
It's,
I kind of want to.
It's quite nice. We got Olympic Village. Olympic Village is pretty dope.
I mostly want to go to the ones that are totally wrecked, though.
Oh, yeah, you got to be in, like, Athens.
The ones that are totally just fucked up.
Apparently, like, the ones from the 2004 Olympics in Athens are just, like, 80% abandoned or something.
Right. Thank you, the Code Machine, for 2 months in a row. I appreciate that. I actually wouldn't be surprised if some artist has already done exactly that idea. I think there's some really good photos to be had, though. Sounds like a kind of cool book. Nice.
Yeah.
Maybe one day I'll make a Patreon, fly around the world.
It's a pretty cheap project.
Yeah, no, it would be more like a passion project. I think it would probably just pay for itself, if anything.
Well, let's see. If you start in like 2000, you're going to...
It'd be an excuse to tour the world, really, is what it would be.
You're going to Japan. I'm sorry, you're going to Sydney, Australia. 98 was Japan. Then in 04, you're going to Athens. 06, you're going to Italy. 08, Beijing. 2010, Vancouver. 2012, London. And then Russia in 2014. There you go. That's a nice little world tour right there.
I think that's a sweet-ass world tour. I'd love that.
Where's the next one? 2016 is like Rio de Janeiro or something.
Well, you got to give it a few years to get really properly ruined before I go take the pictures. So
I
have to have like a cooling down period in there somewhere.
What's going on in my chat?
Yeah, what is going on?
Oh, I forgot 2002. Yeah, Nick, you can go visit Bear in Utah.
I like that guy.
He's all right.
We're going to talk to him later. Ask him about malt liquor. What does he know about it?
I don't know, man. Every time I talk to Bear now, he's wasted.
Oh, yeah, that's true,
actually. It comes out of nowhere.
He's wasted all the time.
It comes out of nowhere. I don't think he drinks that much, but like every time, it's just like an alarm goes off in my head, and I go, I should talk to Bear, and then Bear goes, fuck it! I'm wasted. I'm tired, I'm wasted. I love you, Lisa. Uh-huh. The great moment of payoff when NL checks the chat. I see the chat. I'm choosing not to give it.
What's happening with those pictures? There's pictures all over your chat.
It's not pictures in my chat.
What are those?
A lot of like these with... What are you talking about those pictures? Picture tours?
No, what are those? Yeah, what is that?
I don't know, man. You tell me. You're the guy who knows things about Twitch.
Hang on. Your chat won't stop moving for 3 seconds so I can look at
this. You think, yeah, welcome to my life.
T-tours. What is T-tours?
Tours, man. I don't know. People just use that one.
Is that a global?
I have no idea.
I'm going to try it in your chat. Let me say T-tours. Yeah, yep, it is a global. Sweet. I like that. Oh, thanks, Rumble Muffin. He bought me Face Rig.
Oh, there you go. I can't wait to use that. It's the ticket to YouTube success, man.
That's going
to
be big.
I've been buying a lot of software on Steam.
Oh, my God. I'm going to make so many videos of Face Rig. Rumble Muffin, you don't know how much you just helped me, man. You just paid my world trip to go make the Olympic photo village. What is your chat doing?
Dude, I don't know. It doesn't get any better, though. You gotta accept it. And then when we run the ad, it'll come down.
It'll sort itself out, yeah.
Just a little bit, though.
I kind of like it, though. It's very dynamic. Pretty sure Athens is already wasted on account of them having... Oh.
Why do you always pick the comments that are like economic...
It was the only
striving?
One that wasn't a picture and I didn't read it until I read it out loud.
There's some
sorry.
Dead air. Let's read a comment. Hey, yeah, I'm pretty sure this whole country is already fucked because of their economic problems.
Oh my God, I'm sorry, Northern Lion.
My God. Kate's ruining it. Kate's the one that's the shit disturber.
What did Kate do?
It's apparently the D thing is like a better Twitch TV emote.
Oh, that's why I can see all that. I really like the T-tours.
NL, when are you releasing your Isaac series in 360? Yeah, YouTube 360 is catching on. I've already seen some posts that are like, how can I record my videos in 360 degrees? I'm like, I'm pretty sure there's no game out there right now that does that.
You got to get the neck rig for that, right? With the cameras all around?
I don't even think...
360 face cam.
It would be like a track IR, but... Like in game. Otherwise, it would just be like when you panned backwards, you just see the back of your room. Like,
that's what I mean. I want that.
Oh, you want? So if you like, you can pan on the screen, but then I'll be like Ruka, and then you can pan down and see the cat at my feet or something like that.
That would be perfect.
I have no idea how to make that happen, by the way.
Oh, good save.
I'm amazed that stayed out.
It may have stayed out even if you didn't touch it, but you know, it looked good.
Whoa! that was pretty majestic right there. Whoa.
Ooh.
That's...
I'm not a little bouncy boinger there.
Oh!
Off the top!
Kate, stop ruining my chat! She posts the face and then just types like OMG afterwards. It's like a spam bot.
Guys, why don't we just settle this down a little and we'll go to Hi Guys instead, or Hey Guys.
steamcommunity.com/notafishinglink.com
It's a nice, chill Hey Guys. Everybody likes that. Oh, you're right. Kate's doing it again.
I'm telling you, man. Kate, are you okay? Have you been replaced by a spam bot?
Classic Kate. Nick Telenel, he's not a fuckboy. I think he's my favorite YouTuber.
Not right. A man. Not yet a fuckboy.
I mean, he's pretty much my favorite YouTuber. He's like the only guy I still watch anymore.
There's somebody out
there.
That
counts for anybody. Hi, Boobs Franker Z. I remember that. I love Hi, Boobs Franker Z.
Midfield is just a mess right now.
Did you see? Apparently, Tommy Wiseau had an AMA on Reddit.
Oh, he did.
You must know about this.
Of course, yeah. Namin, thank you very much for the subscription, by the way. The thing with Tommy Wiseau. Is that, and this is the cruelest thing I can ever say about anybody, but Tommy Wiseau became ruined when he started realizing why he was funny.
Oh.
Like, when he was self, I've gone on this tirade before, but when he was unaware, it was great because everything he did was from a place of earnest. Now, he's like, he's playing the character of Tommy Wiseau, and he's like, aha, I'm from dubious foreign origins. Isn't that weird? And I'm just like, dude, just try to make something you actually believe in. Like, don't try to make something.
Right.
And then we'll laugh at it. And I know that's got to be crushing for your self-esteem, but.
Yeah, thank you. That was you kind of set that up for me.
Yeah. I
Guys,
agree.
It's high boobs with a Z, not an S. I don't want to see you making that mistake anymore. Sorry. Go ahead.
Well, no, it's, you know. Mystery Science Theater, you can't really like riff tracks like a Sharknado. I mean, you can, but
it's its own thing.
Exactly. It's self-aware, right? You don't want to be the guy who's making fun of a parody. You'd be like, whoa, this is over the top,
right.
You know?
Then the symmetry is actually that it would be making fun of you.
Exactly. It becomes like the inverse.
Yeah.
Like, if you think you're smarter than the movie, a lot oftentimes the movie's actually smarter than you if it's self-aware. But then Tommy Wiseau became self-aware, which is not to say that what he makes now is good, but it's so bad, it's just still bad. As opposed to being so bad, it's transcendent.
Yeah, yeah.
And I feel for him, because, you know, you don't want to make your whole fucking career being like, I'm going to put out earnest stuff that I believe in that's just going to get shat on.
Yeah. And speaking of shit that's not so good, or not so bad that it's transcendent, please tell me you saw this trailer for the new Adam Sandler movie.
Oh, dude. Okay, so actually, after watching the trailer for Pixels, that guy is in a downward dog right now. There he goes, he's free. When I saw the trailer for Pixels, my brain broke a little bit, and I mean this sincerely. I went, wait a minute, there's no way a movie could be as bad as this looks. So maybe the movie's actually good.
I know what you mean.
It was like,
did it happen the moment you saw Pac-Man? You're like, wait a fucking minute.
Well, there was like that moment at the end of the trailer where the Japanese guy is like, let me talk to him. He's my son. And I was giggling a little bit, and then I realized, I was like,
Pac-Man ate his fingers.
I was like, I'm giggling because of his accent. That's really bad.
Right.
Like, that was like, wait, am I racist?
God,
or is
what
the,
a shot.
Am I racist? Is the film racist? Is,
how
I don't,
did it position itself? So, yeah, that's weird.
I don't know, man. So I think Pixels might actually have to be amazing. Because it right. can't possibly live up to the negative expectations that it's presented itself as. The trailer might as well be like the opposite of Oscar bait, where it's like, it's the worst movie of all time. Like, you're like, well, no one can be, I can't believe that.
Well, they had the part where they show the alien ships, right? And I was like, wait a second, is this going to be like a kind of mediocre sci-fi movie? And then it was like, nope, we're going a totally new direction. Oof.
They have like the farm team Jonah Hill in it too. It's like not Jonah Hill, but it's he like lost the Superbad audition.
Oh my god.
He lost the Superbad audition to Jonah Hill, and since then he's just been like, hey, I got a good lead on this movie, The Wolf of Wall Street, Jonah Hill. Oh fuck.
Oh man. Then they need to run away from Pac-Man, and the only way they could do it is with ghosts, but the ghosts are like Beatles
or
Mini Coopers.
Yeah.
And then the license plates say Inky on them. It's, oh my god.
So I'm pretty sure that like the Austin Corporation probably paid a lot of money for that. It is an Adam Sandler joint, so you know there's...
I want to be like, stop trying to make Mini Coopers happen.
I see them all the time. I mean, I'm like, you know... Looks all right. I don't know. Is it reliable? I don't really care.
I'm just tired of hearing about him all the time. Like, who cares? The car.
We're not talking about Archie, but I wish we were. Whoa, do you see that little... It was like
sweet.
A knuckleball. It took all the spin off of it.
So I think where we're landing on this ultimately is that we're sort of excited for how bad this movie could be.
I honestly, it looks unfathomably bad. So it can't possibly live up to that. I'm almost, because a lot of times I've been like that. I've been like, this movie looks so bad it's going to suck. And then it comes out and it's actually okay.
Sometimes it's just woefully mediocre. So you don't even want to talk about it. It's just like, yeah, that happened.
People are like, you know, oh, well, it's got Peter Dinklage in it, though. So he wouldn't take a bad role. I've seen Peter Dinklage in some... not so fantastic roles.
Inklebot.
Like, have you heard of this show, Game of Thrones? No, okay. For real, though.
I like that show.
There was a movie he did. It wasn't Role Models, but it was like about LARPing, kind of. It had like a post-career collapse Steve Zahn in it. And it was like, this is just...
We need to talk for like an hour about Role Models, by the way, because I watched that.
How do you feel about role models, Nick?
That was a real wild movie that I never, ever thought would end up where it ended up, because I didn't know what movie I was watching for the whole movie. So the premise was not given away by the title, because I didn't know the title.
Mm.
So it was just a weird adventure that ultimately ended up with a very strange shoehorned-in LARPing sequence.
Oh, did you miss like the start of the movie or something?
I didn't know what the movie was about, and I didn't hear the title. It was just on.
So you tuned in like 20 minutes in or something like that?
5 minutes even.
It's like there's some LARPing in the movie.
There was like a, what was the beginning premise? They like drove a car weird and like crashed into a statue.
Something along those lines, yeah.
And then they had to help the kids.
They came like co-opted into a Big Brother type thing or something.
But then at the end they were like very seriously sword fighting for some reason that I don't understand.
I don't know, man. I thought Role Models was pretty good. You see those pictures of Mathis? I bet he loves Role Models.
I think he does. He was really making a fuss about those pictures, too. He put them up on Facebook. He put them up on Twitter. Like, he wanted people to see them.
Oh, yeah. Why wouldn't you?
I don't know. It's just more just the look on his face than anything.
He looks constipated in all those pictures.
A little bit.
I don't know. I thought Role Models was all right. I saw it back when it came out, and then I saw it in a hotel, like, a year ago, and I was like, this is okay.
Really?
Yeah, man.
They were so serious, though.
And that's kind of like the pull, is that, you know, this is like a 40-year-old dude who's like really into LARPing. Plus, they play Love Gun by Kiss, so, I mean, that song's pretty sweet. Love Gun! You know Love Gun. That goes like that.
I was trying to figure out what that means exactly. Like, love, what is the, that in reference
the love
to?
Gun is...
Yeah, what is that?
Don't they have a moment in the song where they talk about... Or in the... Not in the song. In the song, they're like... It's my dick! No. Like, in... I'm pretty sure the Paul Rudd and Sean William Stifler have a conversation where they say the gun is his cock or something like that. The love gun is quite clearly his cock.
I just think they should lampshade it more in the song. Because it's like they might catch the wrong audience that doesn't know what we're talking about,
dude,
and then they'll find out way later.
I think that it's probably lampshaded enough.
Yeah.
I mean, the song is called Love Gun.
Well, does it talk about what the gun shoots?
No. I don't
might
think.
Be bullets.
It does talk about the gun getting red hot, though. And, like, you know.
You might as well just get another goal. You got 9 seconds.
I was thinking about it.
Yeah,
I was thinking
there you
that
go.
Maybe that's exactly what I'd do.
All right, that's what I thought.
Yeah, so
Pixels is the definition of corporate ignorance.
I'm pretty excited to see it.
Yeah, it could be the definitive corporate ignorance simulation, but maybe we want to know what that means.
Our time. So anyway, we're going to run some ads. When we come back, we're going to play some Catacomb Kids. Super duper. See you guys right there.
Super duper.
See you in 3 minutes.
Let's see how big FaceRig is, because maybe I could, like, start it up right now. Oh, it's 2 gigabytes? Are you kidding me?
That's pretty small, man.
For a face cam thing?
Have you seen the high quality polys on that shit, man?
I actually have. It does look pretty good.
I watched a stream of a Japanese guy playing Dark Souls with FaceRig on, and he was just like a fox.
That could be me. I could be that fox.
He didn't speak English, which is fine, because he's Japanese.
That could be me, too. I could just say whatever I want.
But he's like, every once in a while, he'd see like a lot of people speaking English in his chat, and he'd be like, hello, nice to meet you.
Okay.
It was really good.
I'm only laughing because I'm imagining the fox saying it.
It was the fox saying it.
What does the fox say?
Hello, nice to meet you.
It's settled.
Anyway, I'm going to go to the bathroom.
Good luck.
I'll be right back.
Catacomb Kids. They're kids. They go in the catacombs. That's all you need to know. Oh my god. You fuckers ran off and told the Move or Die devs that we're doing a tournament already. We haven't even done it yet. I hate to be the one that tells you, but some artists have made the Olympic book you were talking about. Oh, no. Like I said, I wouldn't have been surprised by that if that was the case. But maybe mine could have my own angle to it. I don't know what that angle is yet, but maybe we could figure that out together, you and me. Better change my game title here. So you guys are all going to want to make sure you get the multi-twitch open for this, because we're going to do some high-octane gameplay between me and Ryan. And I don't know how much practice he has, but I'm actually a little bit rusty myself. I haven't played since I've been away for PAX. But we'll probably get a little further than we did the last time we streamed this. That's what my hope is, anyway. As far as streaming after this NLSS arrangement, I can't tonight, because we've got to do the roundtable podcast. Bear was away. Normally we do them on Tuesdays, and we don't have a stream, but we had to do it tonight after this, so the way the timing worked out, unfortunately. But I would like to, though. Did you start the install at least after stream face rig cam? I really want to, but I can't use up all the bandwidth, unfortunately, to download it. It would probably make it a problem. I've tried to stream before while I download games. It just doesn't really work out. But you can goddamn be sure, Rumble Muffin, I'm going to be using that software quite a bit. It's going to be good. I'm, like, really excited to play with it. Yeah, that's, you can take that to the bank also, what I just said there. Oh, thank you, Rain Kitty, for putting up the Khadgar link. If anybody in Ryan's chat wants to link that as well, feel free.
I don't know how.
Did Nick just tell us there will be some high-octane gameplay? You better believe it.
So much money.
You adorable motherfucker. Could you use face rig on the podcast? I don't know if I want to, but I think theoretically I could. Ah, there it is. Thanks, E-Luke. Oh, I like this question. Thank you, by the way, to Johnny Carson Daly for the dollar donation. Question is, what is the biggest dog you've ever seen that you wouldn't classify as a big dog? I mean, this is kind of, I don't know if this feels like kind of cheating or not really approaching the question properly, but I've seen a poodle that had such tremendous, like, foliage on it.
The ads are playing.
I would almost classify that as a big dog just by virtue of all the topiary shit growing off the back of it, you know?
What the fuck did I miss?
I was asked, what's the biggest dog you've ever seen that you wouldn't classify as a big dog? And I said a poodle with, like, tremendous amount of topiary trimmings on its back.
I can totally understand that.
Keep in mind, Face Rig has a separate upgrade for monetizing. Fuck off! Are you serious?
You just got the game for free.
Yeah, but they want a cut? I appreciate you telling me that, Zeromus, but I'm literally shocked by hearing that news. I didn't think that they would have actually been making this for YouTubers.
Dude, if PewDiePie is going to make like $1 trillion off of it, they might as well get it cut.
I didn't know that this was even a thing people knew about. I just saw it on Steam when I was browsing through shit. I was like, this looks like fun. What's the biggest dog you've ever seen you wouldn't classify as a big dog?
I don't know, like a baby Great Dane or something?
Well, it's gonna be a big dog when it grows up.
It's gonna be big. You want to do some Catacomb Kids, Nick?
I mean, if I said no, we'd play it anyway.
I'm starting my run.
I thought.
Nonsense. How has your Catacomb Kids been going? You've been playing a lot,
it's great.
Right?
I love this game. So I haven't played as anything but bullies still, so don't feel like you're out of your element if you want to use the other one. I don't know anything about them. But I did recently get to a thing that I'm not going to spoil, but it's a thing that I haven't seen yet anywhere else. And not to say that I'm good, because I haven't played in a week, so I'm going to be garbage again for a minute.
Are you playing on keyboard controls or...?
No, I'm playing controller again.
What's roll? Is it left trigger?
Hang on, I got to get into the game here.
Right, face me. Face rig.
Roll is left trigger.
Left trigger.
That's what you said. Yeah. So I feel like if you have questions, I might be able to actually answer them now, other than, like, control questions, because I'm just not... I don't think about that when I play. I just hit buttons.
What you think about that? Now I know how... Now you know how I feel. Want to get with...
My love, no. Gonna...
So you can't handle my love, are you for real?
Are you for real? I died already.
Oh my god. Rumble Muffin just gave me the pro version of it.
Oh, that's what you freaking...
Nick monetized the fuck out of those videos. I was not trying to incite you to do that. I was just surprised. But thank you. I hope that wasn't expensive. I don't even know how much this cost. Shit, man.
I ate the ball of goo. I'm just telling you that much. It's Tim Horton's new offering.
How'd it taste? Like bananas or...
Like everything else at Tim Horton that... Tasted like you microwaved a loaf of bread with like a Kraft single on it.
Oh, that doesn't sound very good at all. I was with you on the loaf until you got the Kraft single involved.
I'm not a huge fan of Tim Hortons.
Why?
I don't find their food particularly appetizing.
It's the Kraft single again.
It's not, I mean, it's edible. You're not going to die if you eat it.
Yeah, well, they have edible arrangements. Doesn't mean I'm going to eat them.
Edible arrangements. Is arrangement always means open relationship, doesn't it? Like, we were on a break!
No, I'm not talking about that kind of arrangement. I'm talking about, like, they have flowers sometimes that they call arrangements, but then you can also get them with strawberries on top instead.
Oh, that sounds quite nice, Nick.
No, it doesn't mean I'd eat it.
Oh, zapped the shit out of you.
Oh, what's your taunt?
Oh, it's... If it's not super duper, I'm just gonna end my life here.
I got on your feet.
Okay, here we go.
Strange. On your feet.
Oh, I got on your feet.
That's a pretty good one, actually. Yeah, you're gonna be fine.
It's okay.
So do you know about the ghost and how important it is to talk to the ghost?
The ghost teaches you the combos.
The ghost gives you 2 free stat points.
Yeah.
Just for finding him.
Okay.
That's a big deal, and I only just learned about this the other day. I haven't even integrated this into my play yet.
Nick, have you ever eaten 5 balls of goo?
Yeah.
All right.
They give you 1 HP.
Really?
They'll give you 1, yeah.
Like, not 1 max, 1...
No, just adds 1 back to your health.
Okay, that's acceptable. I can live with it.
Better than nothing.
Yeah.
Thank you, Goose Feathers, for the subscription, and also thank you for the great art as well. I appreciate it.
NL lives in the... Oh, shit. He just one-shot the hell out of me. NL lives in the Canadian equivalent of Seattle. I bet he only drinks Starbucks. That's not true. We drink blends as well.
Starbucks is okay.
I'm not a coffee snob. I like Starbucks coffee. I'm okay with Tim Horton's coffee, actually, honestly. Like, how do you... Oh, yeah, you put that in your inventory like so. I'll have a Tim Horton's iced coffee and not be mad about it.
Dunkin' Donuts has some pretty good coffee, too.
Yeah? I don't know if I've ever had a Dunkin' Donuts coffee, actually.
I'm on about the butter pecan lattes lately.
What the fuck is that?
It's exactly what it sounds like. It's a latte with the flavor of butter pecan in it.
It's
actually really good.
Nick is wrong. 5 green slimes gives you overheal.
Who cares? Stop correcting me. I don't care.
I appreciate...
I'm kidding. I don't actually...
I appreciate the information, chat. I'm just going to eat these dead bats instead, though.
Thank you, Waha, for 15 months in a row on that subscription. That's huge.
That's crazy.
Waha.
Was that, that was Song 2 by Blur.
No. You know what really surprises me is how much Josh hates my Yaha.
Yeah? No, I think it actually, like, hurts him, like, deep in his core.
I really didn't think he cared that much, but when we were at karaoke, he was like, don't do it.
Yeah.
And he looked at me. He gave me the look that's like, we're going to have a problem.
Well, you don't work together anymore, so he doesn't have to take your shit.
Yeah, that's true. He doesn't. Well, he never had to take my shit, really. I wouldn't put my shit on him. You might put it on your cat. I've heard that much.
He's a wild dude sometimes.
Hey, Kapluff and Ruffinpuff, thank you so much for 7 months in a row. Sorry if I just butchered your name, but I tried.
I think it's pretty... You nailed it right there.
Thanks.
Oh, there's my orb.
You know about eating goblins, right?
What happens if you eat goblins?
Well, you want to loot them and then eat their bones.
Okay.
Not their bones. You want to eat their flesh. Okay. Unless they're poisoned. Always loot them, though.
Sounds like an awful lot of work, Nick.
No, you just hold Y on top of them.
Oh,
really?
They'll
also tell you if they're rotting, which is a problem. You don't want to eat them if they're rotting.
So every time people have been like, you know, you can loot corpses, right? I'm like, this isn't my first video game.
Yeah.
But apparently, you can actually like go to the thing, pick it up, and then hold
Y. Yeah, they have a little menu that pops up, and it shows you all their limbs with their items. It's actually quite useful.
Wait, okay, so you pick it up first?
Walk up to a dead Grumble, yeah, and then hit Y on top of it, and you should be good from there. Oh my god, right on the spikes.
Dead Grumble, hit Y. You aren't holding anything.
B, then.
Pick it up, loot it with Y. Oh, okay. Yeah, give me your fucking shoes. You're getting murdered for your Jordans where I come from.
Throw them over the wire.
I'm from the real fucking catacombs. Alton Amour, thank you very much for the subscription.
Oh, I got a Kratos.
Oh yeah, bats, two bats.
Bats are gonna get you.
They exploded though, I didn't actually get to kill them. Or like I didn't get to eat them. I killed them, real good. I got
and you know
time.
About stowing your orb, right?
Oh, yeah, but you can't take it through the door.
Yeah, you can't take it with you.
I got timed out from Nick's chat for saying rad beats for 90,000 seconds.
That's probably not true.
Oh, shit. Have I been taken in?
I don't think that it does that. It's like, it wouldn't get rad beats and also it wouldn't be that long. I think it's 10 seconds or a minute or something.
Sandals of Blazing and of the Glacier. All right.
That sounds amazing.
That's a really... I'm a little confused by what the effects of this might be.
But that's one of the greatest titles I think I've ever heard for an item in a game. End of the Glacier.
Oh, I stepped on top of this dude's head and he lit on fire and froze simultaneously.
That's awesome!
They're frozen and burning at the same time.
Never, ever lose.
He still killed me, though.
Damn it. You found the best item in the game.
Yeah, I just had brimstone and got fucking destroyed. Okay, super duper.
On your feet.
On your feet, oh. God damn it.
I got an oh boy, that's not bad.
Oh boy.
You like oh boy a little bit.
Excuse me?
Okay. Risky situation there. Pardon me, chat, while I de-rust a little bit on this game.
No, you mean de-salt. Rust
de-salt.
Is Rust is the the one from Face Punch Games.
Really? God damn it.
You got any games you're excited about coming out soon, Nick, besides Bloodborne?
Well, that's what I was about to say 3 seconds ago. I really am looking forward to playing this Ori and the Blind Forest game. It's not coming out, it's out, but I haven't played it yet, so it might as well not be out. I think there's like a couple other ones that I'm not really thinking of.
You gonna play Pillars?
Chasm's coming out eventually, right? That's gotta be soon.
You keep saying that. Your Chasm is like my spy party.
Yeah.
The Witness. I'm like,
spy party's coming out eventually.
It's coming out this year, guys! Get ready!
That was your most anticipated game of 2013.
I think it was 2013, yeah.
Yeah. No, I remember. I went and saw the video. It was on the Circle Jerk the other day.
Oh, perfect. Fantastic. Oh, I didn't mean to drink that. Yeah, I'm frozen, and that means I should die.
Does anyone know anything new about No Man's Sky? Because I want to hear news about that.
It's coming out this year, right?
Hope so.
Yeah. I mean, with No Man's Sky, I'm kind of like in believe it when I see it territory.
I want to buy an Oculus Rift so I can play it.
Buy an Oculus Rift. Try the Oculus Drift.
What, the Tokyo Drift?
That's a totally different thing altogether.
Combine
what's,
them.
What's this? A Curis. Low strength, high speed. No thank you, sir.
You know about leaving the floor by going through the door, right?
Are you fucking with me?
If you want to re-roll a floor and
yeah,
just go back out.
All right.
Sorry, I'm not sure what you thought I was saying.
I thought you were saying, like, to leave the floor, you go through the door. And I was like, yeah.
That would be the dumbest shit ever.
That's a pretty fundamental part of the game, I've noticed.
Should have been a little more clear there.
Mortal Kombat? Yeah, people excited for Mortal Kombat. Sandals of Blazing. Wonderful. What a great name. You think you're going to get Mortal Kombat, Nick?
I'm reasonably morally averse to a lot of the approach that they've had, and yet, even through that, there's a part of me that says I'd probably enjoy it to a certain extent. I don't know if that's enough to really motivate me to spend that amount of money for it, though.
I understand where you're coming from. I don't think I'm going to get it, not because I think it's going to be bad, but because with fighting games, I always buy them, and then I go online and lose, right, like, two games, and I'm like, well, then the value proposition becomes, you know, am I really going to invest, like, 500 hours into this? It's a tall order, man.
The other thing is I'd have to have people to play it with, and I don't think I'm going to.
Yeah. I regenerated.
Also, I need to look at the character roster for it, because I feel like this is one of those ones where they're going to actually make it smaller, which always frustrates the shit out of me when they do that.
Remember in Mortal Kombat 3 when they didn't have Scorpion in it?
Did that happen?
What's up with that? Oh, yeah, I guess I'll just poison a bat, and then also eat the bat after I poison it.
Oh, you can't do that. You'll get poisoned, too.
I'm starting to think that maybe was not the smartest idea I've ever done.
That's fine. I've made that mistake. Yes, I have heard Bloodborne has procedurally generated dungeons. I'm kind of excited about that.
I thought it was... Okay, so I'm just trying...
Some procedurally.
I thought it was like there is a dungeon where you go
into it. Oh, is it just one?
Oh, fuck it. God damn it.
It could just be one. I don't know. I haven't played it.
Nick, this is the run right here. I'm going to beat a boss.
I hope you do.
It's coming up.
I wish you luck. And thank you to Sir Matthias for 4 months in a row on the subscriptions. I appreciate the support very, very much.
Fuck this, man. Spells are too dangerous to bother with.
Actually, if you get the undo spell, that's like your greatest asset. Yeah? You'll probably get to level 4 every time if you get that.
Bloodborne is like Isaac but 3D. Yeah, you pretty much nailed it.
I'd encourage you not to think that way.
I can't wait for all the people who are mad that I compared Bloodborne to Dark Souls. Yeah. Not everything's comparable to Dark Souls, NL. You always use Dark Souls as your comparison. Oh, yeah, this is fuck up that jump and fall on the spikes like a goddamn idiot. Nick.
Alright.
Catacomb.
Game's still fun.
Catacomb kids, man. You aren't playing Super Duper, that's why you're losing.
Bummer.
Oh, that's bummer. That's like the opposite of Super Duper.
Got a regenerate spell, that's pretty helpful.
It is helpful, man. Did you know you can use spells even if you don't have enough energy to use them?
I've gotten that comment a few hundred times now. I don't really understand why. Nobody ever tells me why. They just tell me you can.
Oh my god.
Sounds like you died again.
I died.
It happens. Why did I just use that? Will I do a Shrek through of Bloodborne? Depends if they let me play as Shrek. They probably won't.
Yeah, the door's open. You can come in.
He wants to say hi.
All right. Hello, Ruka.
Kitty.
Why do you want to be in this room, man? It's hot in here.
He just misses you.
What?
It's a little hot in here. Oh, God. Relative to the outside. One of these days, I'm going to get past the first floor.
You'll get past it like this time. Don't worry.
No, I hope you're right, Nick. I hope you're right, but I think you're wrong.
Does this guy have body robe and boots? Nah, don't want them. Eat him instead.
Oh, my God. I got fucking tripped by like four traps, and then my body, lifeless and without direction, landed on a pressure plate, and a fucking thing just dropped on my skull.
Oh, that's shit luck.
Super duper.
On your feet.
That's super duper. I'm starting to get to the point, though, now where I feel like I'm mostly in control of my character, which is huge. It feels so much more comfortable playing the game now.
Oh shit. He made me bleed or something. He turned me into a dinosaur.
That's weird. I do love, though, that there's all these things that can happen that you don't even understand why they happened the way they did until you, like, take apart the situation. I always find that just really interesting.
Store that potato. I'm going to bake it later. I'm scared.
Oh. What are you scared of? Don't be scared. It's just catacomb kids.
Don't be scared, homie. EA, where's
pressure, please.
Where's EA UFC 2? I'm ready.
They've had enough time to make it.
Yeah, the first one was really bad, but so what? Oh, I'm dead.
You know where your life bar is, right? That if you're under water, it'll fill up with blue, and if you're in front of poison, it'll fill up with green.
That makes a lot of sense.
It's just a thing I didn't think to look at, but it's important to notice.
Nick, I need you to do me a favor, because I'm too stupid to do it myself.
What?
I want you to pick up a potato and hold it, and then I want you to get some sandals of blazing, and then I want you to jump on the potato.
What are you talking about?
I want you to jump on your potato with the sandals of blazing and see if it... Oh, it's too heavy! Oh, shit. And see if it cooks the potato.
You want me to cook a potato for you?
With your feet. If it does that, I'm going to give this game a 10 out of 10 right now.
All right, well, I can probably get in contact with the developer and make that happen if that's what would help you find solace in it.
Look, I don't want to be responsible for the game's design. I'm just saying.
I got spaghetti mode added to a game, so I think it's possible.
I don't really want that. There's people who are like game designers. Like they should be designing the games. I'm more of like a game player.
Oh, why? I got stuck between all the traps at the same time.
Yeah, I hate that when you don't know you're in like a
way to die.
You don't know you're in a trap area until you actually get in there, and it's just like click, click, click. You're like, oh no.
It was one of those like three little tiny one block areas, and then at the end of it was a big heavyweight thing, and then at the bottom of that was a teleport trap.
Oh man.
And there was a ghost in there that I wanted to hit up on, but it was also a pressure plate. So I didn't know if I could talk to the ghost by hitting up while also ducking. And then I fell off and got crushed.
Oh. I hear the orb calling for me out in the night.
I don't know more guys than Ohm. That's not true.
It's not possible.
It's not possible.
Is this a bug? Like, when you level up a stat, it turns into two abilities for the next level. But it pushes, yeah, like, the other stat off the screen.
It's to force you to pick a certain kind of direction based on what they give you.
All right, I can understand it.
I'm not sure I agree with it, but...
Right.
It's a weird decision.
On instincts, I'm tempted to say, that's silly. But I haven't really lived long enough to ever make it practical.
Yeah.
Oh god, that rock's gonna fall on my head.
The thing is, we don't really know exactly how long this game is. Right? So that kind of changes how you look at a lot of these early decisions when you don't know if they're early decisions at all.
Can you break a rock just by smacking it enough?
Yeah. Yeah, you can do that. You can also get an ability to lift them and move them.
Oh, okay. I don't want it that bad. Yeah, see you later, fuckboy Grumble. Oh shit, there's like a Grumble school down here.
Yeah, they're learning magic and stuff. You should get them. Get them all.
That won't be necessary.
Oh. He got zapped. He couldn't go back on land because it was all on fire.
Try to get close and your ass will get snapped. My homie Snoop Dogg and Dr. Dre have got my back. Well, that didn't go too well. I can cloak, right? Oh, no. Was that my last life? No! Oh, it's Blink. I got Blink. That doesn't seem good for me. Oh, whoa, dude! I dropped my poison potion in the fire, and it boiled over and exploded into a big cloud of poison.
The way you just said that was so good.
That was a real moment of realization for me.
There's also another one where you can create a new material by dropping potions into lava.
Really?
So you should try that maybe if you get the opportunity.
These grumbles can suck on my grumble.
Seems to be a lot of them, to be honest.
Oh, yeah.
I feel like the first floor should have no grumbles
on
it.
Ah! Ah! There's a turret! Ah, I'm dead! No, I'm alive! Go faster! Oh!
I love those moments. They're so freaking action-packed. Sucks you almost always die at the end of them, but feels good when you're still in. I should probably test one of these.
Super duper. If I taunt right now, though, this guy's gonna get pissed.
Oh shit, everything's on fire. Oh, do you know about melting slime balls? Because they're actually worth more health.
Really?
Yeah, when they're melting, they're better off. So, like, if you get the opportunity, knock them into one of the braziers.
I didn't know that.
And, or, you know, throw a flaming potion, whatever way you can get them on fire.
Fire and ice. All right, I'm going to learn a fire spell so I can cook potatoes.
Really into this whole potato thing, huh?
Hey, punk.
I hope it
hey
works
punk
out.
Hey, punk. That's what I have to say to you, Nick.
Why?
Hey, punk.
I got bummer.
Oh, that's not a good one. That's a bad seed.
Yeah, I should probably throw this one and start over. Come on, Batman.
Oh, shitty.
Fuck.
Shitty dicks.
I get killed so many times by a bat that I don't know can go around a corner. Not cool.
I know what that's like.
Spear of Light.
Oh, goo ball killed me. All right, this is the one right here. I can feel it. Try cooking some mushrooms, maybe. Excuse me, that discussion is against Twitch Terms of Service. Yeah, that was a really smart idea. I'll tell you what, I'll just fall down here and die.
If you find the teleport spell also, that one's very much worth taking.
Is that Blink?
I think it was just called Teleport, but I'm not 100% on that.
Is that Blink, like Dota, though?
It'll say it. Like, if you can get a look at the spell. What it lets you do is just move yourself four tiles in any direction, which is pretty useful.
This guy started with a book. Air dash, heal, break, poison blob. Launch a bouncing ball of poison.
You don't have to.
Sounds a little risky. All right.
Yeah, I feel like doing that would get me poisoned every time. Ooh. I'd like to knock this over and get this guy on fire.
We've all been there.
Nope. Screwed that up. He knocked away my spear, that scum.
He knocked it, like, out of your hands?
Yeah, he knocked it on the ground, and I had to go pick it up.
I didn't know that could be done.
We had one of those, like, parry moments where we, you know, fought for a second.
We answered so fast it was fairy. It was scary. Whole theater in arms when we said Matthew Perry.
What song is that from?
It's the chronic What Ills of Narnia. Oh! Where did...
Yeah. Sound like you forgot about Dre, if you ask me.
You're dead. Not you.
I mean, you never know. Don't light me on fire. Thank you. I freaking tripped. Don't kill me.
How's your pacifist run going in this, Nick?
I don't do that.
You should try it.
I could see reasons why that would be a good idea. I don't think it's a good idea for me.
You're young.
I tried doing pacifism in that one level in Hotline Miami 2. That seemed really frustrating.
How do you even do that?
You had to use a baseball bat or only hit people twice in the head when you knock them down.
Oh, no, you're like weapons. The level where you have to.
Yeah, you have to.
Yeah, okay.
That seemed really frustrating to me.
That's one of the complaints people have had about the game, is that it forces you, on some levels, into a playstyle.
Oh, yeah.
I think they should have incentivized it, but not forced you.
Quantum Zari, thank you very much for the subscription. Well, like, it has narrative purpose, right? Like,
right, but the game ultimately doesn't have narrative purpose.
Well, that's a debate for another show.
Yeah, it
show.
Is. It's a game about mechanics, is what I'm saying, so I think...
I you know, completely agree
Let
with
the
that.
Player enjoy yourself.
I kind of, for what it's worth, I kind of like the variety. And if I play a game and I'm not forced into that situation, like I'm not forced to play different play styles, I'll just be the dude who does the same thing every time. Which is not necessarily something you should be, like, working against, I guess, but...
And also, before everybody gets pissed at me, I actually like the game. This was just a minor gripe. I'm not actually that upset about it.
No, you got your shit backwards, man. Like, people are going to be pissed at you for liking Hotline Miami 2.
Oh, okay. Whatever. I didn't finish the game, so I can't really say with any authority whether or not I like the whole thing, but it's more of the same and the mechanics work, so. That's where I'm at on that.
Am I going to live here? I think I'm going to live. Famous last words.
Oh, wow. Right as I said that, someone asked me what are my thoughts on Hotline Miami 2. You nailed the delay, Anteater.
Are you guys excited about Bloodborne? Never heard of it.
Yeah, what's that?
I really want to play Helldivers, actually. I still haven't played Helldivers.
I want to play Hell Raid.
Yeah, what's... Isn't that like
first-person, kind of Dark Souls-y brawler.
Isn't that the one that takes place in, like, London? It's about vampires or something?
Get out.
Am I wrong?
I don't know what you're talking about. You fight, like, skeletons and minotaurs and crazy shit. from the afterlife, and you have big weapons. Looks like Oblivion, actually, but like better.
Trying to bring down me, the champion. Y'all clowns can't see that it can't be done.
Every time I talk to you, it's back to Will Smith lyrics again.
Every time I talk to you, it's forgot about Dre specifically.
It's because I think you forgot.
I'm very aware of Dr. Dre. Nick, am I accidentally going to teleport myself into a wall with this spell?
I've never teleported myself into a wall, but you get control with it. It lets you put a tile where you want to go to.
Hey, chat. Has anybody played Starcrawlers? I'm looking forward to playing Starcrawlers, Tom.
There's another game with Star at the beginning.
Yeah, no, man.
There's more words than
that. That's like a... That guy's grumbly! Oh, where did he go? Who turned out the lights?
You do not have to do it non-lethal. If you kill, execute two people, he becomes a normal character. Oh.
Really?
Oh. You know what? Actually, people told me that last night, and I just forgot. So, yeah, I guess my complaint had no basis at all.
I didn't know that, actually. Like, I played through that dude's...
Oh, that was a rotten goo.
I played through that dude's whole level and just did it non-lethal.
I got through, like, most of it. It was just the last couple guys I couldn't kill.
Whoa, yeah, it's a ghost! Help me improve myself. Yeah, become a bruiser, become a killer. You're a cold-blooded killer. Teach me how to... I seek your wisdom. Have you tried making a slime souffle? What do you mean it's not implemented yet? Help me to forget. No, don't forget. Forget messy eaters. I can't.
Don't forget. You're
Teach
doing
me
over
how
this.
To fight. All right. What about this one? Down attack in air. I can't do it because I used all my spells already. Ah! Ah! Fuck off! Fuck off!
You know about the mushrooms? You can put them places and use them to jump off of for extra height.
Really?
Occasionally it's handy. Not always handy, though.
I can understand that. Makes sense.
But if you hold them too long, you'll get poisoned, so you gotta kind of balance, you know, put them down every now and then.
How the heck do those fire traps work?
Oh, you just gotta throw a rock through it to break the line, and then it'll kind of just go off.
I was thinking, like, maybe I'd straddle the line. It would be, like, Discord and Wine, and then I'll be on the hunt, and I'll be after you.
I mean, you can actually straddle the line literally, and it'll still just break, and then you can just run away. So, yeah, you're right. You can do that, too.
I'm saying maybe, like, I'd burn the ground and stray from the crowd and be on the hunt. I'd be, like, after you.
I'm surprised you know as many lines to that as you do.
That was previously a go-to karaoke jam.
Oh, got it. So that mushroom deal I just mentioned, I've got to actually do that right now.
How am I going to get out of this bucket of syrup?
And it worked.
Oh, just like that, I guess. All right. Oh, this is where I freaking started. All right, finding another way. Here we go. This is by far the longest run I've had tonight.
What floor are you on?
I don't know. Like, technically two. But I did, like, this is my second floor, too. Yeah. Can you get the orb, go back through, and, like, just farm orbs on an earlier floor?
No, it doesn't work like that.
Oh, I think there's blue torches, huh? That seems dangerous.
I think once you've picked up the orb, like, it won't let you reroll the floor anymore.
All right. I mean, I can get this ghost again, though. Oh, no, I can't. No points. Got it.
Jeez. Fire and ice. Flame wave,
thanks.
Furnace, frostbolt. Eh, I kind of want any of these.
Just aggro him, then get him to fall in the freaking water. No! It was going
like
so
well. Didn't work out.
Oh, I was doing pretty well on that one.
You know to test your potions, right, on all the slimes? That
of
way you
course,
don't have to worry. Okay.
Of course. Of course.
So sometimes you get like a regeneration and then you want to make sure you can kill the thing.
Alright, that's a flame potion. My principal problem in the game is that I get a little lazy sometimes. Can't do that.
Yeah, you really can't. It'll really kill you so fast.
You gotta maintain your diligence. Alright, how does undo work, Nick? Like, if you die, you can just press the button?
No, actually, you don't have to do anything. Just having it equipped as a spell, when you die, it'll just put you back.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it's like an Ankh.
Pardon me? It's like a what?
An Ankh.
An Ankh?
Ankh, A-N-K-H.
It's like an Ankh, sort of. You gotta give me this pronunciation shit, because I get enough of it myself.
Alright.
Ah! Yeah. Yeah, okay, undo's pretty good.
I really like how that just went down.
I threw a potion, and it exploded me and all the enemies.
Yeah.
And then I teleported like 100 times, and it was just like, alright, you did it. You're free. That was unusual.
That's pretty good.
Oh, it's like poison down there. Alright, I'll ignore that then.
So there's a couple of spells, I guess. Like, if you really know what you're looking for, I think you can have a much, much better run.
Yeah, I can understand
just
that.
Just based on that one thing. So shiny. Temporal Tricks. What's this one again? I always forget which books have what things.
Oh, fuck yeah. It's super duper
Slow
run.
Slow haste. Yeah, there's Undo. I'll take Undo.
Undo seems like really good, man.
Undo and Teleport, both of those are like, you have a decent chance at that run now. Probably don't want to go on all these spikes, though. Can I, like, break those somehow?
Oh! Oh, I did a roll because I was like, it's cool. And then I rolled off of the ground and onto the spikes, Nick.
I'm sorry.
Super duper?
Bummer,
yeah.
Oh, I haven't checked mine.
Recipe for a bad run.
I got an on your feet. That's pretty shitty.
Yeah, it's not very good.
I hate this jump. I've got to do two tiles horizontally with an overhang straight above me. I don't know how to do this jump.
Frostbolt.
There's just spikes under me, too.
Gotta be fast here.
Fuck
you.
I mean, I know I have undo, but, like, I really don't want to go this way.
Oh, yeah. It's
the only way, too. It's actually the only way to go.
Oh. I'm so bad.
Maybe, is there a way I can, like, run jump?
Oh, boy.
Oh, that might work.
Oh, boy.
Oh, I did it.
All right.
That jump was awful, but I did it.
How far have you gone so far?
Today, only floor 2. I haven't gotten far at all.
Let's do this shit, man. Me and you.
Well, this is my undo run, so I actually have a chance on this one.
I got some undones going here as well.
I'm gonna put some intelligence in.
Poisoned ball of slime. I don't think I'm gonna eat that.
Throw harder. Yeah, I wanna throw harder. I haven't thrown hard enough.
If you jump into a poison ball of slime, do you die?
Why would you?
I don't know, maybe. Oh, shit. Did they implement that thing recently where when you, get low on HP, it makes the edges of the screen go red?
I'm not sure. I could look at my recordings, I guess, but I don't really notice. It's a good call, though, if they did just add.
Yeah, I agree.
Oh my god, these jumps are awful. Oh my god, I lived. Whew. Buzzing quaff.
Get over here. Whoa, that guy's pissed. Why are you so mad? I'm not even doing shit. I'm so bad
at
this game.
Catacombs.
Alright, I've been undone. Keep an eye out for weapons of rending. Cutting off arms regularly is way better than any of the other weapon effects. That's good to know. There we go. How do you feel about this shit?
Guys, saying I threw, I didn't fall on the spikes. You don't get to say that.
What happens if you eat the grumble corpses, Nick? Like, what happens if you eat 5 of those bad boys?
I think you get some kind of ability. I'm not sure what it is. Probably strength or something.
That seems pretty good.
Yeah, I recommend it. If you can get 5 of them, eat them, for sure. Also, loot them. That's pretty important, too. Oh, fuck.
I'm getting down with the looting principle. I'm not gonna lie to you.
Much of the meat finds itself. Oh, I have Messy Eater for this. Okay.
So shiny.
Just leave these guys alone. I like whatever ability lets me see that there's monsters like slightly out of my.
Oh yeah, it's like telepathic or something.
It's pretty helpful. Okay, got rid of two freaking gas traps. Jeez.
Chat is so chill tonight. Yeah, I think it's like I didn't even make like a promo video for the stream because Twitch was broken. So I was like, it's not gonna work anyway. Might as well not get so many people's hopes up, you know? And then it ended up working out just fine. So instead, we got like nice chat, except for that lovely Momo lady who came in here and fucked it all up.
She's just bringing the hype.
She was bringing the hype. I appreciate it. It really increased my interactions. There you go. These seem like traps.
Ooh, a crown.
I see you.
Oh, he sees me.
My dude said it's wonderful.
He called me a turkey. Yeah, you're fucking.
Every time they say that, I think of you, actually.
I'm not a turkey, you're a chicken.
Yeah, that's the thing.
All right. Loot the shit out of this guy. Oh, shoes.
Oh, teleport trap. I hate you. I lived. Oof.
Four,
put me right next to a grumble.
Four grumble corpses.
Loot it.
Ah.
Nothing I want.
Ah. Oh, 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 no. Oh.
Sounds like it didn't work out. Didn't have an undo, huh?
I did. I guess you only get one use out of it or something?
Oh, yeah. I think it's like one per floor. Like you need a certain amount of charges or something. I haven't really figured out how to do the multiple.
Ooh,
I like it.
I like it. Super duper?
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy's like second best. It's better than on your feet, at least.
Ooh. Where the hell is the exit? Oh, God. Skeleton. This guy's getting a potion of ice.
Nice.
That's if I can hit him with it. Let's see. There's a ghost down here, too, so this is going to be worth it. Come at me, bro. He's got a blue potion. By the way, you know grumbles and enemies always have good potions.
Really?
They're always useful.
That makes sense, actually. You know, it's like they know what the potions are doing. Why would they take a bad one?
Yep. Are you going to jump? Or are you just going to be a skeleton down there? Come on, now. You're making this take forever, man.
Ugh.
Where are we going?
Oh, I missed him freaking twice.
Where are we going, team? Can't be over here.
Teach me how to fight, improve myself.
Nick, did you know the higher your int stat is, the further you can see?
Yeah, it's actually pretty handy.
That is handy.
And did you know that Help Me Forget on the ghost lets you get rid of one of your bad stats?
I did know that, actually.
It's a useful one. Let's get rid of Messy Eater.
Causes your like food to be less effective or something?
Yeah, he wastes a lot of food that way.
Okay.
Wait, it forgot undo? Oh my god, I hit the wrong button. Off. I just wasted the ghost. I'm pissed.
Well, you just imagine it was like an angry ghost.
You're harder to notice, crouch side.
Oh, yeah, good. I dropped my potion of invisibility on top of the grumble. I was trying to use it.
Oh, I learned manners, so I still got rid of Messy Eater.
That's funny.
Face me.
I'll face you, baby. Just get out of the way. Should have looted him before I ate him, right? Before I eated him.
You can still loot them after you eat them, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
That just seems cruel.
It's kind of, yeah, it's demoralizing for them, but they kind of deserve it. They're being such dicks for no reason.
Oh my god, I rolled into the wall and my dude shit the bed.
Oh, am I cooking that potion? I am. Do not gas me. Do not gas me!
Oh.
It's not funny.
Clutch D. No, don't die to a gooball.
Sounds really racially insensitive.
Kind of does. My daddy said, never trust a man what's made of gas. Nah, you gleegop, you're one of the good ones.
Daddy was a good man.
Yeah, Papa was a rodeo or something like that.
He was actually a rodeo, yeah.
If you eat a smoldering dead biat, you gain more HP, Nick.
Did you just speak Russian?
Maybe.
That's what I thought. This may be one of the strongest characters I've ever had, actually.
I'm glad to hear that.
Oh no, choice between two unimplemented options. Alright, we're adding speed then. Oh, bats are here. I think the bats just show up sometimes, just completely at random. Magical combat. Heal. Can't believe I lost my undo. That was the dumbest shit.
Oh, shit.
You can kick in doors by attacking while you're pressed against them. Yeah, it's just like in Hotline Miami, actually.
Megaton of stopping.
Is that a hammer or something?
That's a hammer. Oh, sounds my cool. God. It takes about 75 millennia to be able to swing it, but...
Mm-hmm. May not be worth it, then.
Nah, dude. It's a big hammer.
Oh, okay.
Now, it actually seems like it kind of sucks, but it also, like, freezes enemies. You pick the meat from the Grumble's corpse.
Do not wake this guy up. Oh, yes, he's so quiet. Do I really have to go through this bullshit mess again? Oh, fuck, here we go. Okay.
Oh, that's like a very convenient place for the exit to be. Get away, get away.
Because of the teleport trap, I had to go through this really long bunch of traps multiple times. It was not pleasant.
I comboed the shit out of you! Oh, you're doomed.
You don't sound too happy.
I'm mad.
I'm kind of mad too, because I have to fall into a place where I can't see and there's no other option. Don't do that. Okay, I was gonna say, if that was spikes, F this. Also, this is garbage. How do I get out of this?
Terrific.
Oh my God, I need a freaking raft. This jump is garbage. Don't knock me in the lava, please. Still alive. Still alive. Oh, I lived.
I got hit by three fucking piranhas simultaneously. They all jumped out of the water at the same time and all hit me.
I made it off floor three.
Oh, dude, that's amazing.
I'm at the shop.
I've never seen a shop in this game.
You may have and didn't notice. You can walk right by them.
I don't know, Nick. I like the shop.
Okay. Shop sucks. Shop is nothing I want. Big deal, so I can get a golden version of my weapon. That doesn't help me.
Are you kidding me? That's fucking amazing.
It is, but it doesn't help. The stats are all the same. Alright. At least we said we went.
High HP. 5 HP. I don't care if
oh
you're
my God.
A bad swimmer.
What is that?
Is it the boss?
No, there's like a rat that's covered in ice or something, and it looks really weird. This isn't the first time I've been to floor 4, is it? I hope it isn't. That would be really awkward. This is a skeleton man.
That awkward, don't worry about it. On your feet. Oh shit. I thought I was having a good run, and then I realized I had on your feet, man.
What's that all about?
Well, it means I got a bad run. You ain't a poet, dummy. What, I don't even know what it means.
You used a key command that's meant for the poets, and they're telling you don't do that because you're wasting your time.
I'm just button mashing.
Okay, I don't know where to do this progression. Warm thick. All right, I'm gonna toss this warm thick at the skeleton.
Warm thick? Sounds like you're talking about love gun.
I mean, I was trying to hit a bone with it.
Yeah, but what does the bone mean?
Bones define us?
Oh, yeah, okay, I hit you in the... just... fuck
exactly,
off.
Right? I agree. You start just saying a lot.
I know how that is.
Eat the rat. No, eat the poo-poo. I can't believe I'm still alive this long. This is now my cue, now that I've said that, to be absolutely killed. Oh, there's grumbles galore up here. Oh, there's a skeleton too.
Oh, I've done it now.
Oh, I killed everybody.
Oh, good.
Oh, good.
Loot. Nothing.
That's the first time I've ever looted that, like, super dangerous area and gotten out.
I don't find that it's all that worth it most of the time.
Apparently, my new weapon, when it hits enemies, it has a chance to teleport them to somewhere else on the map. Well, I'm not sure if that's as useful as they would like to think it is.
Kind of interesting, though. Something different.
No, you're not. You're definitely, definitely not wrong about that.
Cool and smelly. Warm breastplate. Okay. Are you playing super slowly and meticulously, or are you still kind of running through stuff?
I just run, man. That's how I've lived my whole life, right? Running.
I've been going real fast, or real slow, rather, and it's actually paying off. I really don't know what this is. This is a rat covered in ice. It's creeping me out.
Don't be a fuck boy. Okay. You're straight out of luck, boy.
I really want to just go through this exit so I can say that I got beyond level 4.
Do it, man.
Oh god, I just gave a bat strength. I'm done.
You died?
Yep.
Oh man.
I died from full health because I gave a bat strength in front of the exit to level 4.
Oh shit.
That is absolutely the dumbest shit I've done in this game yet. Yeah, I'm done.
You're just quitting.
Well, we've got 4 more minutes. I guess we do one more run. I'm mentally done, though.
Oh, yeah? I'm in, man. I feel like I'm hitting my stride.
That was my stride. That was it right there. Not a reason in hell I needed to die right there.
Oh, is that supposed to be dangerous or something?
Deadly distance.
There you go. That would have killed the shit out of me like a week ago.
You're getting better, though.
Yeah, that's very true. This is the one where I'm going for it, I'm telling you.
You're going fast, though. You're going to be in trouble.
Oh,
got to be careful.
Mr. Speedrun telling me not to go fast here.
I don't get it.
Called you Mr. Speedrun.
Doesn't matter.
Don't ever jump at me unless you're prepared to die for the cause, mon frere.
What is the cause, really?
I'm not really sure, man. We're just in the catacombs.
What's the cause of getting out of the catacombs?
I don't know, man. That's what you're going to find out in your series.
I got some warm thick for you right here.
Don't ever say that. If you did a series on this, I would watch the shit out of it. Well, you're in luck. One person on the show has done a series on this game.
I'm only 7 episodes in, though, so, I mean, that might be good. Maybe you can catch up if you're interested.
Try to come up this way. Oh, yeah, I got the trap stuck to the bottom with the goo ball. I've never really found a practical application of that, but...
It just feels good, though, that you can do it.
You're like, I manipulated the environment in a way that is, like, meaningful. So, potions that the Grumbles have are always good.
Yep.
Strength potion. That does seem good.
It is. I guarantee it. What doesn't kill you makes you donger. I like that.
I'm just going like full speed stat.
Give me power. Actually, the free run stat is pretty useful if you go in that direction.
That's what I have right now. What does it do?
Kind of lets you just run around walls much easier. So, like, if you want to run up a corridor, you kind of just hold run, and your character just does a lot of the movement for you. It's a little difficult to explain, but just, you know, run at stuff and see what happens. See, that's why I like this game so much. There's a lot of really meaningfully different things that happen based on the way you set up your character.
Certainly not wrong about that.
Finders keepers. All right, this Grumbles got wrecked.
Worthless.
Worthless.
Shitty boots. And, oh, robe. Nope, don't want them. Now I'll take the Bardish. Bardash?
Yeah, I don't know, actually. All right, this one's going well.
What is this blue death corridor? What does this mean? There's just blue smoke hanging out in the air here.
Oh, remnants of a trap.
It's the gas, but the gas isn't stopping. I'm not sure if I was supposed to go through it. Didn't hurt me, so I guess it's fine.
Oh shit, I think I fucked this skeleton's life up, man.
Somebody's gotta do it.
Okay, help me improve myself, please.
Yep. So glad I know about the ghost.
Why would I ever want Breath Holder? Absolutely not.
If you want to go swimming with the fishes. Every now and then you run into a level where you kind of have to go in the water. It's not great.
Oh, this is the run right here. I can feel it.
All right, all right. Combat complete. I'm just destroying Grumbles left and right now. Mashing up their bodies. Oh, fuck off, wait. That was just bullshit. That shouldn't have killed me. I was standing next to a stationary weight and it started to lift up and it killed me when it lifted. Didn't hit me into anything either. It just, the fact that it moved near me killed me.
I don't have any learning points left. This one's gonna happen, man.
It's apparently pronounced Bardish.
Oh, there's a shop!
Yeah, see? Told you to get there. For sale.
I have no money, though. Have you ever tried to murder him?
I haven't. You could be the first if you want.
I'm not going to do it, I think.
Every time I've ever made it there, it's been a big deal, so I haven't really wanted to, you know, make waves.
Oh, what is this thing? There's like a freaking Electro Raphael from the Ninja Turtles.
What does it look like?
I thought
it look like a rat covered in ice? Because I went through that whole thing.
Yeah, I think that is actually it, Nick. I think it's a rat covered in ice. I'm serious.
I didn't know what it was, to be honest. So
I think it might be a rat covered in ice.
It also looked a little like a stingray, in a way. It had like a weird tail poking out.
Yeah, there was something going on.
Oh, and when I killed it, its tail shot out, so.
Oh, well, it's 601, Nick. It's 601.
I kind of feel bad that it's 601 now that I've started to get back in again. What are you going to do? All good things come to an end. I'm just glad we could stream today.
Me too, man. That was fun. Do you want to take a second to pimp your channel?
Thanks. I wouldn't mind doing that if you don't mind. All right. So you can come find me over at youtube.com/rockleysmile. Indie impressions nearly every day. I've been kind of spacing them out a little bit differently lately to see how that goes. Catacomb Kids Let's Play if you're interested in watching more of that, as well as a variety of other things. We're going to be doing another tournament, as Ryan mentioned. That'll be up there. And, well, just go take a look. There's weird videos like pretty much all kinds of things. You can also find me over on twitter.com/rockleysmile if you want to follow my variety of cat pictures and life events. That stuff's all documented there, as well as when I go live for streams on twitch.tv/rockleysmile. Thank you again, everybody that subscribed and resubscribed today, as well as the donors. Really appreciate the support. There will be more streams, of course. I've got a ton of games that I want to get to streaming. I'm not sure when exactly that's going to be, but I'm thinking Friday, Saturday region will probably be the safest, because today we got the podcast, tomorrow we got Magic, so no post-NLSS streams, unfortunately, but there will be more streams. So thank you, everybody, for sticking around.
Hey, thanks for watching the Northern Lion Live Super Show. It'll be back, conceivably, with no breaks, Monday, the Wednesday, and Friday, so we will be back tomorrow. If you're interested, you can subscribe. It's $5 a month to subscribe. It gives you the opportunity to play in our once weekly subscriber streams, as well as the emoticons that shall be nice enough to show off. Today's subscribers, according to Moobot. Big thanks to all the resubscriptions as well. But today's subscribers, according to Moobot, we had Monster Punter, X Frosty Penguin Z, or X Frosty Penguins, Cerberus 189, The First Sterling, Sinvicta, Legal Mango, No Mean, Altanamore and Quantum Zari. Thank you guys very much, and thanks for taking the time to watch, especially with Twitch being borked up. And if I'm going to be doing shameless self-promotion, I might as well mention that we do still have a shirt for sale as well, teespring.com/twitch/northernlionmarch. You can also head to twitch.tv/northernlion and scroll down. It'll be just past the video pane, and you can see that the shirt is for sale there. In fact, if I do a little bit of video magic right here, I can probably put it up on the screen. Gonna have to give me a moment here, add screen region. There you go, right there. Designed by Dracula Fetus. Have a nice little picture of me inside of your pocket, available for the next 7 days and 1 hour and 55 minutes and 55 seconds. Thank you to everyone who has at least considered purchasing it. Even if you didn't do it yourself, that's totally fine. And thanks to everyone who supported our previous merchandise ventures as well. Now, it is 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Kate? Yeah. You streaming? Yeah. Kate's gonna be streaming. What are you playing, Kate? What are you playing, Kate? Kate? What you playing? She's playing City Skylines. I'm pretty sure you can also go to YouTube or twitch.tv/alpacapatrol, and he's playing City Skylines as well. But I'm going to be hosting
my
wife.
Oh shit. Oh shit. That's a waste. I just found a boss and then immediately died. Sorry.
All right. See ya then.
Later, everybody.